Yeah, in my walk with the Lord and in many dangerous places, I've always seen God come through. And all of a sudden, the thought hit me, well, what if this is different? And there I was in prison in Iran. It was out of my hands. There was nothing I could do. Either God would do a miracle or I would stay there. They put me in a cell in isolation, had a light in one corner, and that was on 24 hours a day. It was in the winter time, there was actually snow outside, but the heater didn't work well. They only let me out of the room to be interrogated, which was once a day or sometimes not at all. And then they would lead me down this hallway and take me into the interrogation room, which was an ugly room. It had blood stains on the floor, very dark and murky. It was definitely the most terrifying part of the whole experience. The beatings would start and it would be slapping in the face, hitting in the stomach, sometimes kicking. I struggled with faith. Was God with me? Did he love me? If God's good, why would he allow me through the situation? And I remember one day I woke up and I was done, you know, inside. And I remember waking up that day thinking to myself, if I'm going to be here the rest of my life, why not check out? My only thought was not to stay there. And the only way not to stay there was to die. I stuck my head in the sink, I filled it up, and tied one end to a bracket, put it over my head, and then hopefully would tie the other end tight, thinking that, you know, with my head in the water, in a few minutes I'd be gone. Four times I tried to kill myself, but every time I tried, I was too scared to tie the other end. And I'll never forget the last time. Again, I tried. Again, I was like, come on, do it. And again, I just couldn't do it. I couldn't tie it tight. And I remember at that moment jerking my head out of the water. And if I was ever aware of my brokenness, I was aware of it at that moment. And I remember falling down on the ground, and I was broken. And if I was ever aware of my shame, I was aware of my shame at that moment. And I remember lying down on the ground in that moment, all of a sudden the room fills with this glorious light. And I turn around to see what's going on, and there is Jesus. And he's standing in front of me with this big grin and smile on his face. And it was at that lowest point that he met me. And he looks at me and he stretches out his hands and he puts them underneath me like this. And in the vision, as I see Jesus, he looks at me and says this. He says, Dan, I love you and I promise to carry you through this time. And from that day until this day, I've never had those thoughts again. And that's who Jesus is. He meets us at our lowest and he can rescue us from the depths of us. And he wants to give us life in the midst of the pain of life. And he meets us and he loves us. And he wants to rescue us no matter what we're going through. I found out indirectly that I was under two death sentences, one for being a missionary, one for being a spy. And again, in that prison, I heard executions, yeah, quite regularly. And it was my moment in a courtroom. I stood on the stand, hundreds of people in the room, video cameras, judges. And then came the question. Tell us today, sir, why? Why did you come to Iran? Something rose up within me, the power of God. And I remember looking at the judge and saying this, I came to Iran to tell you about Jesus Christ. And when I said that, I'm like, oh, what did I say? And all of a sudden, I said it again. And then I said it again. And then something started to grow in my heart. And for about 20 minutes, I just preached the gospel. And I told everyone in that courtroom, and I told everyone who could hear me, all about who Jesus is, all about how much he loved him. All of a sudden, I realized something. I am free. I am free. So what if they kill me? My life is bought by the blood of Jesus. My home is in heaven, and no one can take that away. And I realized that in the midst of death itself, God gave me the grace to stand up and speak the truth. And in doing so, it brought freedom in my heart, knowing that this life isn't it. There is more. And I'm going home one day, and no one can take that away.